And for over a decade now, and would like to show you a little of life here. After high school, I went to American River Junior College, then to San Jose State University. After graduation, I moved to Japan, which is about the size of Montana, but half the population of the United States. The population is 120 million people, and the Tokyo, Yokohama, and Kawasaki area has 22 million people, about the population of California. My family and I live in Kawasaki, which is just outside of Tokyo, and I have two girls. Emily, who is in elementary school, and Jenny, who has just started nursery school. My wife, Taiko, spends her days keeping them out of trouble. We live in the J building, apartment 404 of a newly built condominium complex, which is very convenient to either Tokyo or Yokohama, and can get anything one could possibly need within a few minutes of the apartment. In spite of its small size, its price is about 2 to 3 times most 4-bedroom houses in Sacramento. We were lucky to buy it before the prices shot up. With the population density, the Japanese know how to conserve space. Let me invite you to my home to show you what I mean. In our home, like all Japanese houses, you take your shoes off when entering the house and put on slippers. One room in our apartment is a multi-purpose Japanese tatami room. Japanese often entertain around a table like this. You can keep your legs warm in the winter. There's not only a blanket, but a heater under the table as well. The tatami room is also used for sleeping. Japanese, until recently, slept as well as entertained on the floor. The kitchen also conserves as much space as possible. Japanese baths are different from Western baths. You wash outside and just soak or relax in the bath. Usually all the family members bathe together until the children reach adolescence. Then they are separated by sex. Before getting married, I was a poor graduate student and went to the public bath every day because I couldn't afford an apartment with a bath. After a while, I used to love visiting friends every night there. If you have to go to the bathroom, you have to say toilet, because the bathroom and the toilet are separated. The washer and dryer is, of course, small and compact. Our condominium complex is very special for Japan, especially in the center of the city. There are several buildings in the complex, and everything is very conveniently located. Emily's school is only 3 minutes from our apartment. From Emily's school, a short distance away, is my sports club. I go in the evenings 3 times a week. In the club, there's aerobics, a weight room, and a pool. I usually work out with the weights, have a swim, and sit in a sauna for 12 minutes. Shopping is also 3 to 5 minutes from the house. There is a small grocery store in the complex. A 7-Eleven is less than 5 minutes away. And a large grocery store about 10 minutes away by bicycle. When we shop, we usually travel by bicycle with the kids on the back seat, like most families. This is our local drugstore. Notice that most of the goods are outside and unattended. Crime in Japan is so low that most shopkeepers rarely worry about theft. In fact, the local police spend most of their time giving directions and meeting people and children in the area. There is one of these police boxes in almost every neighborhood. We very much like getting on the bike and going shopping, but that's not the only means of transportation available. The roads are almost always crowded with cars, bikes, and people. Driving is slow and time-consuming, even to go the shortest distance, and the trains have priority. Therefore, I like riding the trains. There are 2 trains near our home, one going to Yokohama or Tokyo, the other to the center of Kawasaki, which I ride to go to work every day. As you can see, the walk is not far. I walk for about 7 minutes, although I could jump on the bike and park at the train station. I peacefully buy a ticket, enter the train station, and ride the train for another 7 minutes. I get off the train and face the crowds at Kawasaki Station. Going to Tokyo is even more crowded. I work my way out the exit. Down some stairs. And to the bus area, where I catch a bus for a 10-minute ride. I could walk for 25 minutes. As you can see, there are other train lines at Kawasaki Station. And plenty of taxis available. To increase efficiency, all taxi left rear doors open automatically. I arrive at work at 8:30. This is the Isuzu Motors Training Center. I am involved in training Isuzu overseas dealers. Regarding vehicle and truck technology, sales, service, parts, and overall dealer management. I'm not too busy while I'm in Japan. Most of the time, I'm involved in developing training material for seminars overseas. I'm usually traveling to various countries around the world from one-third to one-half of the time. Different from the United States, while I'm in Japan, I am speaking in Japanese, and surprisingly, I can get a lot done with quick conversations in the cafeteria. On my way home, if I am very hungry, I can have a bowl of noodles at the train station. or have a beer and yakitori, which is grilled chicken, weather permitting. Quite often, I buy some yakitori chicken and take it home for the family as a snack before dinner. When I'm not traveling, I try to spend as much time as possible with the family. Our number one activity is playing tennis. And along with working out at the sports club, I like to jog a couple of times a week, and I enter a local marathon every month. Some weekends I coach the local second and third grade boys on baseball. Maybe it's repayment for the great coaches I had when I was a boy. Baseball is the most popular spectator sport in the country, and people watch pro baseball religiously. Sumo, Japanese wrestling, is also very popular. Being the father of two girls, we usually buy food and fresh vegetables and eat at home. But if we don't want to cook, we can make a phone call and have a pizza at home in less than 30 minutes. Or order sushi, and by scooter, have it delivered to the door. So we can have sushi without leaving the house. The bowls are picked up a couple hours later. Also, beer by the case, dry cleaning, rice by the bagful, and in some cases groceries can be delivered to the house. Of course, we could eat out, for example, at a sushi shop. Yakitori shop, as well as a full range of other Japanese restaurants. In the past 10 years, many Western restaurants and fast food shops have come to Japan, like Denny's. Kentucky Fried Chicken. And McDonald's, which is one of the largest fast food restaurants in the country, surpassing many of the traditional local foods. Well, that concludes my life here in Japan. It's very different from California, but in many ways it's exactly the same. Many people have asked me if I would like to retire here. Well, the answer to that is no. The pace is just too fast. Also, old people don't have a lot of recreation available to them. They mostly play croquet, called gate ball here, and stay at home. Hawaii, California, or possibly New Zealand is more appealing to me. I hope you've enjoyed.